Hey everybody, how you doing? My name's Kelly and welcome to my nighttime show. I don't have a title for it though. Tonight I'm going to show how to take an old canvas that I did. I think this is like maybe 5 by 7. I'm not real sure. It's a smaller canvas. I went through my closet today and found paintings that I did not want to keep anymore, and threw them away, which I usually like do over, but I couldn't do it, so I threw them away. And I kept this one because this had, I don't know what I was doing at this point. Hi, Seabead Lady. Hello, everybody. Well, I'm so excited. I'm gonna redo this. And I kept this one because I figured it would be small enough to do on the table. The other ones were big and they just weren't, really cool. And I don't know how many of you are like me who do. I thought I was really cool and I did this as a relief and this is the stamp. You know what I'm saying? And then I thought, wow, I'm going to hang this on the wall. And I never did because I don't understand why I did the black line underneath like this way. What was I thinking? Maybe I should have put a black line going this way or in between. I don't know. Yes, I threw them away. I know you guys were behind me, but so I thought it was pretty fancy making this, like, oh, you could find this at HomeGoods. Let me put some gold on it. I didn't put the gold on it because then after I made it, I hated it. So, yes, I threw away a lot today. I know, and I don't do it often. I usually reuse canvases because with no matter what you put on your canvas, whether you put fiber paste or molding paste or papers or it looks like crap like this, you can always do over because with mixed media and stencils and all that kind of thing, you can just layer, layer, layer. So you don't have to waste a good canvas. I did today. I wasted a couple, but there's stories behind them. So, yeah, this is what I did. Now, if you'd like to do it, this is one of those cheaper foam stamps you get at the craft store, like the big, you know what I mean? And like in my head, it looked really, really good. On canvas, it didn't come out that good. So, I'm going to move the camera down. Now, everybody can hear me. Everybody's good. I know you're a little bit behind me talking, which, but I'm going to move down. Move it down, move it down. Okay. Let's try to get it on here good. And see how we can do this. Because my camera's being a little jerky. A jerky turkey. Okay. Hard getting like everything on. Okay, we'll just set it like this. Okay. You need a life do-over? I need a life do-over also. I'm like, is this day over yet? All right, I'm reading real quick. You guys are kind of behind me. You have this stamp share? Well, look at the fun that you can have with it. Hi, Dixie Doodles. Oh, I got 19 people. Very excited. Okay, so here I go. So these are some things. We all have things that we do that, whether it can, now, look, if you don't have canvas that you are going to do over, it can be a piece of watercolor paper. It can be a piece in your art journal. I've done many art journals that I've done over the picture because I really didn't like it. So, some ideas, okay? Now, I'm gonna put these stencils aside. What the heck? I went and got all my stencils. Now, here's things you can do. And I haven't decided which one I'm doing yet. However, you can take stencils and you can take your molding paste, and we've made molding paste. I know a lot of you use the molding paste that we've made. However, today I got quite the surprise when I was watching Annie's new video, and you should check it out, where she makes Gesso, it has nothing to do with molding paste. What are you making, Annie? Gesso with what? Or is it molding paste? She'll answer in a minute because you're behind. But anyway, she made something like completely different than a way than I do it. So once she hears me, she'll answer the question. However, okay, so we can do, like, you can take your stencils, and this one's kind of big, so I would probably put it in the middle if I was going to do that. Or you can use your smaller ones and do, you know, a stencil that you want to do. Now, for me, I've never used, I'm waiting to see if Annie goes, oh my gosh, everything falls. I'm trying to read while I'm opening. I'm going to do, no, my art. I've already done one in my room, I think. There you go, Annie. She made gesso with spackle, water, and acrylic paint. Uh-huh. So I told her she needs to do a video on that because I don't do that for gesso. I do it differently. But that's how she does it, and I would love to see it because that's quite interesting, and I would like to get in on that gig. So if I use this, and I was smart and I got some spray ink, let me grab some. Where is my spray ink? Try this. All right, I'm coming. I'm sorry. I meant to grab the sprays and I forgot, of course. And then I can use these. Okay. I'm coming. I know. So prepared. Okay. So. This, I love these, the walnut ink antiquing solutions. So this is a great thing that you can use. I'm just going to use some glitter mist. And I think I'm going to go, because the colors are yellow and red, I want to go a little darker. Hi, Cynthia! Oh my goodness, you guys are making me so happy. Did you have your coffee? Okay, these stencils are called, these are from the Crafters Workshop. Most of my stencils are. So this is an idea to do. And I'm gonna do the darker color up here. Now this is might not even be dark enough. These have shimmers in them. They're the shimmer mists, the tattered angels. And it's a beautiful color, but it's just not going to cover what I want. So I'm going to do one layer of this. And this is just an idea because I'm going all out. Now, what do I always tell you guys when you use stencils what to do, which I do not have on me right now? What is wrong with me? Always have, you're going to hear things fall. It's okay. Always have a piece of paper to lay on your stencil. Actually, you lay your stencil on the paper, but I'm not. So you can lift up, and then you get the extra, so you're making another mixed media piece over here, which I did not do. Now, you're not going to be able to see that very good because it really was a crappy, that was a crappy spray. But it did it kind of antique it. But I'm not really digging that, so let's move on. Because what we're really going to do is this. I don't know why I bothered doing that. I thought, oh, how fun. No. Here's the fun thing. Tissue paper. Yes, have paper nearby. I always say that. Have your paper nearby watercolor paper or mixed media paper, so you could take your stencil and put it over so you get that extra ink onto another piece of paper. Now, this is tissue paper, okay? And it's wrinkled, and I like the wrinkled look. And this can be any color you want it to be. Now, I also have, which I love to use, I don't know which one I'll use tonight. Maybe I'll just use this. This came in my order I got the other day, and it's just paper bag. So when you go to the grocery store, buy paper, you know, grab a couple paper bags and bring them home, because watch how much fun we're going to have watching me glue paper bags to this. But you get a great technique. Tiff Tiff, hey baby! Who else is here? Rose! All right, Taylor, take care. Oh, you don't suck, Tiff. So all you do is take your brown paper bag and rip it into pieces very fancily. All right, I'm going to throw it on the floor next to me so I can grab it when I'm done. Because we want to cover. Now, this is crunched up, okay? You see, like, oh, look, it's garbage. No, it's not. Look. Look how fun and fancy. It's fun and fancy paper. So, take your, you can use Elmer's school glue or any type of school glue that you have. And just put a little bit of water in it because you want it to have an easier consistency to use. You can use Mod Podge. Maybe I'll use Mod Podge today rather than, yeah. Let me use Mod Podge to show you. If I can open it without having to call my husband. Oh, I can. She's a winner. Okay. So you just take, and I have this thing of Mod Podge. It's matte, not gloss. And I'm going to smear it down and get these. I asked my husband to get these cables out of the way. I don't know what happened there. Okay. And I'll be quick with this so you guys don't get bored. But, and I'm going to give you a tip. Like, if you have your brown paper bag and you want to do this, something that really is fun, and don't care if it hangs over because we're going to cut, you know that, and we overlap. Wet your paper and then crumble it up. Like, let's pretend like we're wetting, wet it in the water, and then crumple it up like this, right? My hands aren't working good today. And then just set it overnight. When you wake up, I gotta turn my computer so I can read, because I feel like I'm the left out child at school when I can't read. Then when you wake up, when you undo it, you really get a cool texture. Now look at that, just that. So when you wet it, it dries like that, and then it comes out, and then it's just delicious. And then layer on your paper. And don't worry, we're not like being fancy schmancy and worrying about it hanging over the edges, because we'll take care of all that. This is a really cool technique. And I just run some Mod Podge. I don't think you need my green cord, whatever the heck's that for. If you hear yelling and screaming in the background, my husband and my daughter are not abusive. They have been obsessed playing games, and sometimes they get a little loud. I'm just saying. Crumbling, look, crumble. This is going to be, what do you see? It's going to be so awesome. And not because you all are awesome. Because you guys are awesome. Oh, no Mod Podge under there. Oops, don't want it folded over. Look, mistake. Look at that. Fixed. No problem. Push a little hard so you get the bubbles out. Now, you can also use your credit card or old Mac card or old whatever, debit card, whatever they're called nowadays. Oh, Robin H. How do I know you, Robin H? I want to know everybody, and I want to know how. My God, you guys are giving me such awesome tips. Do you know how many times I scream my husband's name? And I don't mean at night. I'm sorry. Okay. just open the bottle that I can't open. Look how fast and fun. Fast and furious, she puts the Mod Podge on. Now, you don't have to cover everything, you know, if you don't want to. If you want to leave some of the color underneath exposed, it's up to you. It's really your painting. But one good thing about this is that you know it's going to be covered. And I do, I mean, you can put a whole piece on here. That would be pretty awesome, but I don't want to embarrass myself more than I already have by doing it and then having to cut it and do all that fun stuff. There, while I lay this down. Oh, okay, great. Okay. I am horrible. I just want y'all to know I am horrible with names. I'm lucky I remember my own name. Honestly. So please excuse me and don't, like, feel like, you know, I'm this, like, wicked mean person. Well, I am sometimes, but not all the time. But I am horrible with names. Really. And most of you who know me, which a lot, most of you in here know me, know I rescue animals, and between my dogs and cats, they're called every other name under the sun, but their own. So I yell at, you know, I'll be like, stop doing that, you know, Spyro, and it's not even Spyro. Which, I've gotten more questions. Little Willie! Woohoo! My girl. I've gotten questions on, and then I have to tell you this, because it's hysterical. I always get questions on my dog, Spyro, because he's laying with me here. He's the only one in here. The other one's hoping that they eat some food out there and they get it. But he is my animal, how you say, how do I say this? My animal familiar, I'm going to say. But he's me in a dog form. And my husband always says he's so dramatic like me, and he's loud like me, and he's whiny like me, and, you know, those wonderful loving things that husbands after 24 years or whatever it's been say. And, but anyway, he never leaves my side. But the other day, he was being rotten because when I record and he's sleeping and I bother him, he will sigh, like he gets upset, right? So I kind of yell at him, like, Spyro James, because his name's Spyro James. Spyro after the game and James after Jim Morrison. Anyway, so, I'm sure y'all know who Jim Morrison is. So, he's my secret love when I come back to in the world again. But so people always ask me, like, about him. Like, is it a person? What's his name? People always call him the wrong name. And the other day somebody thought, and I thought it was so cute, and I can't remember who did it right now because I have a horrible memory. They thought his name was Spider James. And I thought, damn, why didn't I think of that when I named him? I thought that was so cute, calling him Spider. Because we've had some cats that we fostered that we've named that have had wild, wild names that we love. But I've never named one Spider. I thought that was really cool. Anyway, that's my story. Doesn't matter. It makes no sense. Anyway, so we're back to arting. And you see, is he the snaggletooth one? Yes. Oh my God, how freaking funny is that fart pad? Hi, Marilyn! Oh my God, 25 people. There's my girl, Chris. That's who it was. It was Christy. She called him Spider James. That's who it was. I just saw her name and remembered it was Christy. Christy Rella. My girl. Yep. But I do get, people do message me. They message me funny questions. And then I have to, like, either rewatch. Oh, need more paper. Yeah, I was talking to Susie Blue the other day, and I've gotten more request. Like people always say, like take pictures of your walls of your art and all that kind of stuff. And Susie and I were talking, and she was like, "You have to take pictures of the dogs. Take videos of the dogs." So I'm gonna take videos of my dogs, because a couple people have asked. Of all my dogs, all my rescues. And my cats, because I can't forget my cats, because I love my cats. But yeah, Spyro's the one who's always in with me, black and white. All right, you know what, Catherine? It reboot. Can you reboot on a Nook? I have 9 dogs. I had 10, bless his soul. He passed a couple months ago, I think. Right, Annie? I can't remember. She's my memory, which I don't remember much of nothing. But they're all rescues. Most of them, my husband and I were talking. We always talk about it because, most of the dogs that I have right now would be gone. They would have been put to sleep because they weren't, nobody wanted them and people gave them up. And they're not, my husband's dog, Cubby, wait till you see the picture of him. He has like 3 teeth. He's a hot mess. But we've had him, I got him right after my son died. And he's lived this long. And they were gonna, put them down. I say kill, 'cause that's how I feel. They just kill them like they're nothing. And then and Cubby's sister, they're overbred. I know I've told this story a million times. I'm such an animal freak that that's why I talk about them so often. So I won't bore you anymore, 'cause I'm sure you've all heard my stories. 'Cause I am an animal lover. Oh, I'm sorry, Penny's mom. Well, they do. I've been fostering. My husband and I have been fostering for, gosh, 20 years, give or take a year. And we foster for the shelter here in New Jersey, and we foster for, it's called Love a Chin. They're Japanese chins. They're rescue that don't have, they don't have places, but they're rescues, so they rely on people to foster. And Saved Whiskers, which is a cat rescue, my girlfriend owns, and we foster and all for there. And as far as my dogs go, these are dogs that we took in to foster that nobody wanted. And so then we paid a small fee, 'cause the fee goes to the, because like with Cubby, who is my husband's dog, they had to take all his teeth out. Like when he was so overbred, and he actually won things that, what's that pet thing they do when the dog show? He actually won like medals and stuff the dog show. If you look at him now, you would never know. But he was so overbred that, and they didn't take care of him, so all his teeth were rotted out. And I think they saved, once the rescue got him, they saved 4 of them. And he's just a hot mess. But I couldn't, neither could my husband, see him being put down. And like I said, we got him right after my son passed. And we were just talking about that. Like, it's been 3 years. Like, could you imagine him? They put him down. And he still lived 3 years. And his sister, what happened with him was they tried to breed her. This is bubbling a little bit, needs a little bit more. They tried to breed her, and she's a smaller Japanese chin. And what happened was, one of her babies got mummified in her rib cage, and then she could only have one. So she was very she was kind of nasty when we first got her. We had to train her, but they were gonna kill her because they said she was nasty. I'm like, geez, if I had something jammed in my ribs, you know, and you had to, they had to take it out. So, hey, Carol, you made it. How was darts? It is a crying shame. And if it wasn't for my husband yelling at me, no more animals, because he can't stand, you know, he said to me, you know, I can't stand the, I'm gonna use a little bit of the tissue paper now. You know, when they, because we've taken in so many older animals, and Japanese chins are a lot of what we have. You know, they pass. Like, we had one of our Japanese chins who was my husband's, not necessarily my husband's dog, but anyway, you know, he passed all of a sudden, like out of the blue within like 2 days. And, you know, it gets sad, you know what I mean? But we do it because we love them, and, you know, but we can't, like he always tells me, we can't save them all, Cal. You know, and I want to. I want to hit the lottery so I can get a farm so I can have my own rescue. Because that's what I'm going to do. All right, I think we're good playing with the glue here and all. You know, but you look at the cats. Like, I know Annie's a cat freak. I love cats. My daughter's a cat freak more so than a dog freak. I love them all. But, you know, you look at them and how would you even imagine? Knowing that somebody doesn't, you know what I mean, doesn't want them and give, you know, give them a home. I want to take care of them. All right, I'm going to dry this real quick and read. Refreshed and it didn't help. Yeah, when I hit the, I keep saying when I hit the lottery, because I'm going to hit that damn lottery. And everybody who comes to my shows and Annie's shows all the time will get a piece of that. Because I'm going to win. There ain't no doubt in my mind. I'm just giving this a quick dry just to get most of the moisture off. I'm not worrying about it too much. And I did not cover it all. If I sat here and was perfect doing this, we would be here all night. And we all got things to do, I know. I'm very blessed and thankful that y'all came. All right, so can you see how cool that looks? Just with paper bag. Yeah, I know, Cynthia. It's hard, and like my husband said too, he's like, you know, we're in our 40s now, and like, I'd like to travel and do things, and we can't because we have all the animals. And not that it's a that he damns the animals or doesn't want them, he does, but he's like, you know, you don't think about that. So he keeps telling me, you know, I don't want you saying yes for anymore because they ask me constantly if it was up to me, but it's not, it's up to both of us. Okay, so yeah, and it is, especially when you have one, it's really hard. I mean, we have, you know, we have quite a few, but you know, when you lose them, it's no matter what if it's a cat or dog, whatever it is, it's a it, they're pieces of your life. They're like having your own, you know, children. We just, as a matter of fact, the cat we just lost. Her name was Bowie. I don't want to say it too loud because of my daughter. But we got her. We rescued feline positive leukemia cats, feline leukemia positive cats. And after my son passed, we took in four kittens that they were going to euthanize. And three of them passed on at variations of time. And I wanted to take them because my son had died, and I just thought, like, okay, this is good, you know? And then three died, and then one was left, and it was Bowie, who just passed a couple weeks ago. And it's so sad because, you know, you don't, whether you have 10 of them or one of them, it's just so sad. And I can't find my things that I brought over here. Where'd you go, sir? All right, let me move these out the way. Now, let me show you something really cool. This is with just a, this color's cocoa. Now, I'm going to show you how to do it with a stamp pad, and I'm going to show you how to do it with, you know, we love you sitting through buffering. Oh my gosh, who's in, who's Lyrical 66? Tell me your name, love. Okay, so can we see this texture right here? Because I'm trying to stay, you know, because it's a bigger canvas and I need to set up my other camera. I just haven't. But if you just take this and run this over, and I'm going to hold this up for you. Now, if you have a darker color, it's awesome. But look. Look how it picks up just on the top. Okay, so that is like freaking awesome. So I'm going to dry it. And then I'm going to get out darker brown paint and show you how to make a faux leather. Look. I think that's the dye black, but that's going to be too dark as far as the ink. But I'm just showing you how to use an ink pad. Some people don't have, you know, paints or ink pads or, you know, whichever. So if you have one or the other. But I like using a bunch of things. Lisa, okay, hello, Lisa. I'm getting so, like excited and overwhelmed with, like, all the people here that I thought, like, really, Annie and Vanessa were going to be the only ones here, and I see Vanessa left. Was she sick? I must have missed it. I kept whining to my husband. I'm like, I think I'm going to be alone. Okay, so this is burnt sienna. Now, you can use any color brown you have. This is just what I grabbed. I usually use folk art. I just grabbed this. I've had this for years. I'm just putting a dot down. I'm taking a sponge. You can use a makeup sponge. You can use a brush. Let's use a brush because most people have a brush, paintbrush. And I'm going to leave it dry, all right? But I'm going to soften that up a little bit because you know sometimes when you put it in the water and then it dries and it kind of gets hard? Yeah. We'll stop there. So I'm just going to dab it in. Dab it in. And then I'm going to bring you in a little bit to where I'm going to do it at. Okay. So I'm just going to lightly go over kind of where I went. Because that's already going to be on there. Now don't fret. It's going to look a little... brush a little bit now and bring it on because you know acrylic paint with water. Now if you have a spray bottle and it's much easier, get back. If you have a spray bottle, don't spray. I'm gonna spray myself in the face. I'm so excited. Don't spray yourself in the face. All right, so now you're gonna kind of rub it in. And you don't want to work too long in one space because it will obviously rip up the paper. Plus, my paper wasn't completely dry, so. And I'm only doing this one side. Now, you can see I have some, like, yellow showing through and all that. And you can keep that just as the texture. And I'm going to put a little bit more. I wish I could find my thicker because I'm using that thin crap. Gets on my nerves. Let's try the color. That's maroon. Oh, I don't want maroon. Being prepared. Trying to be prepared. Let's see if I have anything in here. I wonder if this would work. Talk amongst yourselves. I'm coming. I promise. Let's try, which I love, the Liquitex ink. And this is called Transparent Burnt Umber. Let's just see what happens. Ooh, that's dark. Ugh. Came out a little darker than I anticipated. Let's see. Oh, it looks cool. I'm gonna have to pose. But it comes out so pretty. Now, if you have acrylic paint in burnt umber, that's what I would use because you want that darkness. And I'm gonna show you in a second once I run this over. All of it, because I want it to kind of stain that. Oops, I got it on my pink Betty Boop pants, pajamas. Now, I want you to look. Let's see if you can see it. And I'm going to blow it dry in a minute. Can you see that sitting in those corners of the crackle, like the paper that's crackled? Believe me, I get to my point when I'm around, when I get to the, you know, it takes me a minute. Oh, it's cool. You know what it is? And this is how I did it. I'm going to tell you how I did it. It's Liquitex ink, and it's by the paint, and it comes in a million colors. And what I would do is I don't know what your situation is, but make your significant other and your children go in with coupons to AC Moore, and you buy three colors and use a coupon. Now, I also look in the ads because they run sales in them all the time. So I have quite a few colors. I also bought myself, which I'm quite afraid to use, I bought me the Dr. Martens India inks? I bought the set series 1 and 2, but I haven't touched them yet because I don't want to, I'm scared. They were not cheap. And I couldn't use a coupon, which coupons are my best friends. Alright, can you guys see how beautiful that looks? Can you see the leather look? So, like say, you know, everybody's into making their own art journals and journals in general themselves. Can you imagine getting a composition notebook? Like, I'll show you. Excuse me. I hope you can't see my butt. Okay, this is, I gessoed because I was going to do documented life, but then I didn't do it. But I was going to do this on here. So I gessoed it. But all it is a composition notebook that the kids take to school. Do you know what I'm saying? So imagine like getting a journal or making your own journal and doing this on this. And it looks like it's faux leather. How can you beat that? I don't think you can, honestly. I think that was more a rhetorical question. Okay, so I'm just going to very lightly blot up just to get any extra moisture. And you see it's really not changing it. So, that's that. Now, if I didn't knock all my stuff over. Let's say you don't want to do, let's see if this works, this color. Let's say you don't want to do the brown leather. I love this dark. I love it, love it, love it. And I'm going to show you, like, I'm going to give it a chance to finish to dry. And then I'm going to, what did I do with it? I was going to put a clear coat on it to show you when you put a clear coat of this on, or if you put glossy Mod Podge or glossy, Collage Podge, or you know, any type of gloss on top of here, how beautiful it looks. So, but right now I'm gonna take a violet color, violet, not violent. And over here I don't have as much texture, but let's see what we can get by lightly running it over the lifted parts, because you don't have to do it leathery. I like the leather look because I don't buy leathery, like leather things. My husband did buy me a book of shadows of leather, but that's all I do. That's all I have, leather, because I don't like leather. But look at that, and look how beautiful Now you can do the same thing that we just did by rinsing out your brush, adding water, and start bringing it in. Now this is, looks like it's permanent, but I'm not gonna worry about it too much because I want it to spread. Hope you guys can see that because that light's kinda, plus the, is it too, I don't know. I don't know what I'm doing here. Light's going everywhere. So I'm just gonna do this and give this some of this. And then I'm gonna grab, I have to have purple paint because I don't want to use stuff that you guys don't have. Let's try, that's gonna be too light. See what happens is I start things and then I'm like, oh, let's go from, like, in my head, it starts. So I'm just going to put acrylic paint down. It's apple barrel, petunia, pickle, purple. Very easy. Wet your brush a little bit more and just run it because we want that dark to come through. And we'll run it over again. It's not a big deal. We just want this to stain that underneath a little bit so we have more color contrast. And this can be any color you want. I'm going to leave that sit for a second, and then we're going to blot up. Let me read real quick. Okay. AC Moore is East Coast, Arizona. Yes, Bert, those puppies ugly. Oh, leave me alone about those Dr. Martens. My friend Elaine bothers me. We're both scared to death. She keeps bothering me. Did you try them yet? And I'm like, no. Oh, that's Singagan. Singagan goes to Cha. This is Cynthia McCoy. Light blue? Oh, interesting. I would like light blue. Gold? You can do it with anything that you want. Vanessa said she's still... Oh, there's Vanessa! Your name's not coming up... I don't understand. It says I have 26 viewers. It's showing me. Oh, there you go. Oh, my. Angela, Annie, B.L. Moffitt, Carson, Christy, Cynthia, Dixie, Vanessa, Carol. Jerry, I know your name and I can't remember it, but you're not Jerry. You're, starts with a C. A C? Catherine, who's Little Willie, Lillian's Art, Linda, Lyrical, Marilyn, Midnight Lizard, who are you? What's your name? So I know your name. Robin, Rose, Penny's Mom, Celia, Tiff Tiff, awesome. Okay, so this is sitting. Apparently I'm sitting, not doing anything, looking at names. So excited. So I'm just going to give this a little bit of a wipe because I really don't want it all to go away, but I want some of it to go away. And it's showing a little lighter here. Maybe I could have picked a little darker of a purple. I don't know, but I'm going to dry this. So like Annie said, she used blue. I used for the leather look and I'm using purple. So you can use whatever, Claudia, there you go, baby. Jerry for Claudia. I knew it was a C. Are you guys all friends with me on Facebook? Friend me, Kelly Donovan. Although I curse sometimes a lot if you don't like that kind of thing. But you can ignore it. But friend me and join all our groups. We have Art Journal with Annie. We have mine, All Things Creative. We have, you know, I think that's all we have. We have our YouTubes. All right, so I'm just going to lightly go over them big things. Oh, my God, I love it. Oh, my God, oh, my God, oh, my God, oh, my God. I wish you were all here to see. Oh, I freaking love it. I just feel bad if somebody leaves and I don't get to say goodbye. Goodbye, my friend. Goodbye. Now I'm just gonna dilute it. I'm gonna dilute it. Gonna dilute it. Just a little bit around the edges. Not playing with the middle, because the middle I'm in love with. I'm gonna give it a little hit with the gun one more time. That water bottle is gonna fall. Let's see if it does. I don't care. Because I'm in love with brown paper bags. Okay. It did fall. My bad. Okay, look. Look how cool. Now, I wish I would have done the bottom layer a little darker purple, to be truthful. You can friend me tonight, baby. Well, Cynthia McCoy, you're my friend on Facebook, so you know the kind of stuff I do. I put on a pair of underwear today on my Facebook, you know, or the other day that if you fart, you know, it's an air freshener in there. Some might not find that humorous, so you just scroll past. All right, so what do you think of the purple? Isn't that beautiful? I'm just holding it because I'm, like, staring at it. Like, it's so freaking awesome. Look at that. How cool. And then let's go to our leather side, which is my ultimate favorite. Can you imagine? Look at that on it as a journal cover. Looking, 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 looking. Ignore that red on the front that I cover. So we have two different colors, right? And all it is an old canvas. And I did this for me. I'll use this as a background for mixed media. I'll fix up the pieces that are kind of lifted up a little bit, and I'll glue them to the sides and do all that, and I'll use this. But you see, let me read. Yeah, I love the purple, but like I said, I think for underneath it needed to be a little bit darker, maybe. Maybe not. What do you guys think? I'm not using caulk tonight, sorry. No caulk. I used caulk the last show. If you want to see the caulk, you go back to, you can watch my show from last week or on YouTube. Right? The dead trees on top. I mean, this looks like it's like, I mean, look, and this is really dark. I mean, let me just show you again. It is really, I mean, it is really cool looking. And like I said, when you do this, like for instance, you know, over here I have a lot of texture. I have a lot of wrinkling and that kind of thing. Over here I didn't do it as much. Oh yeah, Halloween. I love dark art, so that looks great. But like I said, so over here I didn't do as much texture as here. So you can see the difference. So if you only want a little bit of texture, don't, you know what I mean? Make sure you spread your brown paper bag or whatever you're using. Like I said, here's tissue paper right here, as you can see. But you can see it also sucked up a lot of the brown. But that just adds to the background. So to me, that doesn't bother. You like the pale purple? I love to quilt. I am a quilter. I love it. I love it, love it, love it, love it. All right, let me read some here now so I can read. So do you think any of you guys would try this? I know Annie did already. Yeah, I made more texture on the brown to show. That's why I kind of did the two colors, because I made a lot more texture here. Oh, good for you, Marilyn. I've not put anything into, but I love to quilt. I love to quilt. I love Tim Burton. I love anything dark. And I love horror movies, as you all know. and I love foreign horror movies, and I love to see blood and guts and torture. Although I would not do that to anybody unless you really made me mad. No, I'm kidding. You know what? If you use plastic bags for this, you would have to use a paint that worked on plastic. And I know that, like, folk art and, like, what's that lady's name? Martha Stewart. They make things for plastic. So, yeah, you would have to buy a specific paint for plastic. So, do you guys like this? Do you guys like the... I'm going to ask you now because I'm kind of ahead or behind or something. Do you guys like the leather look better or the more subtle look? Or do you like more this? Now, let me show. I'm gonna put some gloss on here because I want you... And it's already kind of glossy, as you can see. And I don't know why. But while I'm sitting here, I'm just going to gloss this up real quick. I know, this is not healthy. Don't do this at home. I shall turn my fan on now. On high, so my dog's ears blow in the wind. He hates the fan on too. But it'll just generate the smell, and then they'll yell. You'll hear them yell in a minute. So let's leave that dry for a moment. Ooh, you could put glitter on there or something. My dog's mad. He just got up. He's like, "What's that big fan on for?" Okay, I'm reading. You like a more subtle look? Yeah. Well, that's the fun thing too, is that you can, all right, let me just give this a quick once over. Oh, this water bottle is going to be the death of me. If it isn't the smell of spray. Now, something else I want to talk about very quickly. All right, I'm just going to leave the fan on for the rest. I'm going to tell you, this Liquitex ink, like I said, you go in, it's where they have their at AC Moore, where they have their, where you can buy their Liquitex mediums and like the watercolor paints, you know, individually. And you'll see them. It's just called Liquitex ink. They're on the wall. They come in a million colors. I have, this is what I have of them. And let me just show you a few colors just to wet your whistle. Look at that blue. Is that not a beautiful blue? I should have used that. Oh, I should have used this purple. This is Quetiapine Magenta. I can't say the word, but look at it. It's not really purple. It's like a pink. And they also have, as I'm spilling everything, they have gold. I'll take the dog hair off that one. They have gold. This is gold. It's called... Iridescent Bright Gold, gold, and yellow, orange, azo, so it's like a yellowy orange. Just trying to find, I have a lot of that magenta because I really dig it. They have Prussian Blue Hue, which is a very dark blue. They have white, deep violet, which that would have probably done Moroccan on there. Deep violet, but I don't want to waste time looking. Green. I did the Roy G. Biv. You know how I always do Roy G. Biv? Those who follow me on YouTube. Red, orange, yellow, green. What is it? Red, orange, yellow, green, blue, purple, black, and white. And then I pick in betweens. So those are some really great colors. There's a silver, too. There's titanium white. Let me find the silver. There's a copper. You can see the copper. I know, really thrilling. But anyway, here's silver. And this is the iridescent bright silver. So they have a lot of colors. Like I said, there's a lot of colors I'd like to get. But I just really pick, you know. And I have, mind you, No, these are AC Moore. I bought those a while ago, and like I said, I don't buy anything without a coupon. So like I said, when I tell you, unless they're on sale, when you can't use a coupon, so I see when they're on sale and I would go buy them, and I would use coupons and make my husband go in with me and my daughter. And sometimes, you know. Yeah, the colors are beautiful. Maybe next week I'll do something with them all to show you like what the colors look like on like a gesso piece of paper or watercolor or whatever, so you guys can see. Now, let me move the camera up so I can talk to y'all. Well, that's some shit you don't need to see there. Look at that. Look at that Italian curly hair up there. But yeah, so let me see. All right, thanks, Carol, for coming. Oh yeah, copper teal and brown would be awesome. So, Nikki, what do you think about your first live show with me? Are you ever coming back? Will I ever see you again? Will we be friends? Oh yeah, black brown. I love black brown. Black backgrounds. We don't have Hobby Lobby here in Jersey, so I have to buy online, but you can use a coupon and if you buy online, and also AC Moore is going to be, I think it's next month. They're going to be, you can shop online on AC Moore and use their coupon online no matter where you live. So that's going to be a big thing for those who don't have an AC Moore by them. I got these all those acrylic inks at AC Moore. I've not looked at Michael. I don't think Michael's has them. Annie, what do you get from Michael's? The inks that you get, which are like these, but they're not Liquitex. Annie gets a different brand, but they're the same basic thing. Good, Nikki. I hope you do. Annie's will be, well, do you were? I mean, like, are you available? Because you're like, it's like tomorrow afternoon already where you're at. What time is it if it's 1 p.m. Eastern here? Can you do that in your head? I don't know. I might have to look that up. Annie's channel's name is Corner of the Bedroom Studios. And Annie, if once you hear me here, because we're a little delayed, put your link in, your Ustream link for your show on Monday, on Thursday at 1. Andy will hear me in a minute. Oh, there we go. Yeah, F and W in a six pack for $30. And now those are the ones that are at Michael's, and you can use a coupon, and it's the same thing as those. That's PM in New Zealand. Oh, so you're opposite. Is that late PM or is that like 8 p.m. or is that like PM my butt's in bed PM? Oh, 3 p.m. I'm so confused. I can't believe I have so many. I have four guests who I don't know who they are. So thank you guests for coming. I hope next time to make an account, it's free, and to come in and chat with us, I would love that. So I have four guests. And 25 viewers, and I am beyond. Why are you censored, Annie? I am beyond blessed. I am beyond blessed, blessed, blessed that y'all came. I am so lucky. Thank you guys so much. I thought really it was just going to be me and Annie and Vanessa. Oh, it's 3:30 tomorrow afternoon now. But what time is it if it's 1 p.m. here, Eastern, in the afternoon? If it's 1 p.m. in Jersey, Eastern time, what time is it for you, Nikki, over at your place? That has to be nighttime, right? Now, here's the thing. I have to allow links. I thought I did. Wait, I'm gonna put the link. I'm gonna look. I'd swear I did. Chat options. Okay, I put a loud link, so I did. I clicked the thing again. Annie, put your link in again, babe. Yeah, what we do is now I did a night show, and Annie, I don't know why I'm yelling, and I think the fumes got to me, and now I'm a little like, which I'm normally like that, so whatever. I did a night show today on my Monday. Thursday, Annie will do her day show at 1 p.m. in the afternoon. Next Monday, Annie will be live 9 p.m. Eastern, and she'll be at night. And then I'll be at the day on Monday. I should have said me first. Does that make sense? This Thursday, Annie's at 1. Next Monday, I'm at 1, and Annie's at 9 on her Thursday. Oh my God, we got the schedule and all things creative. We're alternating nights. And there's Annie's Ustream. Thank you, Vanessa. I'm trying to explain like how we're doing it. Like, so every Monday, one of us is going to be live and we're alternating it at night. Does that make sense? No, that's not right. I think the fumes got to me. Bye. Thank you so much for coming, Lyrical 66. I am just loud. I'm normally loud. It's Italian from Jersey. Yeah, well, I'm getting ready to close shop too. So don't forget to m meet us here on Thursday on Annie's channel at 1 p.m. Eastern. I will be live again next Monday at 1 p.m. in the afternoon Eastern. And then on Thursday, Annie will be late night at 9 p.m. We will be putting this in All Things Creative, Art Journal with Annie. You'll see it everywhere. Friend me on Facebook. Friend, I don't know if anyone's friended on Facebook. Do you want friended on Facebook? Thank you guys so much. Thank you, Linda. Bye, everybody. That's leaving. Bye. But okay, so I'm gonna close my show. So I want to thank everybody who came. You guys rocked my world tonight. It was better than the season premiere of Walking Dead last night. That's how good I feel. And it's not me smelling the fumes. So y'all really rocked. I want to show one more time the used canvas, and that's the leather side used with just paper bag, and you can see all that texture in there. And then this is the purple side with less texture. And that is our faux leather. And the reason that I clear coated it is because I'm going to work on top of it. So that will stay on the bottom if I want it to come through. And it's dry, and I'm in love with it. Love, love, So I hope y'all have a great evening. And if you're watching this recorded on Ustream or YouTube, I hope you guys sub and will be to one of my live shows. So I want to thank everybody. And as always, be kind to everyone, as you never know what battle somebody else is fighting. And peace out, peeps.